because I remember, spoilers, it was Ross before, wasn't it? Like Admiral Ross was the mole inside Starfleet Command in Deep Space Nine? Yeah, it was Ross. All right. So it's Suspect and War Games. I don't remember, recall War Games being very lengthy. Shutdown, I remember being lengthy. So I'll just do War Games. And I think that'll be it. You've already completed this mission, yeah. Let's see. Starfleet Command wants an observer to evaluate your crew. You've done great things for us, and we have no doubts as to your abilities, but we have missions ahead of us that require a ship and crew operating at peak performance. Ha ha. I see what you did there. And Command wants to make sure that you're the right person with the right ship. First, meet up with Captain Gora in the operations room. He will accompany you to a War Games exercise in the Draylon system and evaluate your progress as commander of the USS Woglinde.
Finger chess!
Admiral, then you are ordered to proceed to the Draylon system for a combat training exercise. Your opponent in the War Games will be the USS Athens, commanded by Captain T'Valla. She is a formidable opponent, and the Athens has been upgraded with state-of-the-art technology. I'm eager to see how she performs in combat. She's still a piece of shit, Typhoon, isn't she? Your ship's computer will be modified so that you register hits and take damage, sarcasm quotes, but neither of your ships will be harmed. Don't hold back. We want to see what you're capable of. The most advanced technology ever is a shitty Typhoon. Let's see. War Games. Okay, War Games. Go to Deep Space Nine. And then again, almost every Typhoon I've seen lately has been morphed into a command battle cruiser. I think that was the point. I think that's what the command battle cruisers were intended to be. Because they were talking about, like, a Typhoon redesign for a long time. That they wanted to put in something reminiscent of a Typhoon because a lot of people liked it. But because a lot of people really liked the Typhoons. They were really cool-looking Franken ships. And, Cryptic was going, we're probably not going to make the Typhoon playable, but we're probably going to replace it with something that is better but reminiscent of the Typhoon. And the Command Battlecruisers, like, when you look at them from certain angles, they certainly are very Typhoon-like. So, I figured that's what they were intended to be, is that these are the legit Typhoon replacements. I noticed you used Photonic Fleet back there, and it spawned a Typhoon, which I thought was colossal overkill. I remember when Keldons were a threat. Jesus. Like, Keldons were, like, a huge threat, like, early on, because they would just, like, destroy you with, like, swarms of, like, holographic galores. Excuse me. Yeah, the galore's feedback pulse. All of those holographic galores would be feedback pulsing you, too. So, I remember, like, that was when... that was when flying escorts required tactics. Like, you actually had to know how to hit and run... like an enemy capital group in an escort, instead of just parking there and like hitting like cannon scatter volley and annihilating everybody. Tactics, what's that taste like? Oh, that's gonna get annoying. I have pedal to the metal, and it constantly does that. Oi. And there. 10. Okay, 269, station control, walk Linde, we're ready for you to dock. There have been some renovations. There haven't been renovations in years. I'm almost always at full throttle unless I'm taking a tight turn. Dock at Deep Space 9. This place looks a lot better than it used to. That's not saying much, though. I remember Deep Space Nine used to look like garbage! Captain Gora, hello there. Hello, Admiral. Admiral Quinn, he's told me a great deal about you and the Walkland days. Might have to observe you during these war games. I hope you do well. Is there anything would you like to ask me? Is there anything you would like to ask me, rather? Tell me about the war games. You'll be skirmishing with the USS Athens. First, there will be a space component. Computer systems on both ships will be adjusted so that you may fire weapons normally, but no harm will come to either vessel. The computer will register hits, however, and may shut down affected systems for a period of time to simulate battle damage. If you do well in the space battle, we will move on to a boarding action. You and a small team will board the Athens and attempt to capture a predetermined location. This won't be easy. Captain Tavala is a formidable opponent, and she and her crew have extensive combat experience. Tell me about Deep Space Nine. I'll tell you all about Deep Space Nine when we get to it. What's the current situation with the Cardassians? Ah, the Cardassians. They lost so much during the Dominion War. The orbital bombardment of Cardassia Prime left much of the planet in ruins. Millions were killed. After it was over, the Federation pledged to help the Cardassians rebuild. We couldn't give them everything we'd hoped. The disputes with the Klingons, the destruction of the Romulus system drained much of our resources, but we did what we could to set them back on the road to prosperity. The Cardassian people have turned misfortune into opportunity. They've held free elections and chosen democracy over oppression. They've rebuilt their industries, and with the help of the Ferengi, they're selling starships and technology throughout the quadrant. Someday they might even be ready to apply for Federation membership. Not everyone is happy about that, however. There is a group of Cardassians calling themselves the True Way that want to return to the old ways. They want the Obsidian Order taking people away for interrogations. They want fear and conquest. Most of all, they want to rule the Cardassian people with an iron fist and dance the Ferengi dance, which is the most distracting fucking thing ever. The True Way has a lot of former military officers in it, and they've even managed to get a hold of the military-grade ships and weapons. They're causing a lot of trouble for us in that area, and I think it's time Starfleet cracks down. What are our orders? I'll join you for the trip to the Draelon system, and I'll stay aboard the USS Waglinde and observe during the war games. I'm looking forward to seeing you in action. I've heard nothing but good things about you and your crew. And you obviously haven't heard much. Alright. 3,500 energy credits. How about no? Or 35,000, rather. Yes, leave the system.
I went right in the face.
Okay, that's the Vlucta asteroid belt. That's the Draelon system. That's a star! Look, I know with, like, the shields we have, one could theoretically fly through the corona of a star, but still, it doesn't mean that you've got to do that. I think the auto nav in this game needs serious work. That's what I'm saying. Clear the shit out of my inventory, Jesus. Boy, get out. Get out. You are RCS accelerator, get out. Get out of it. Finally breathing normally again. I do like that we have lots of, like, dual star systems and, like, different types of stars represented. That's very nice. Although they could do with a little bit of work on the immersion. But overall, it's like the new sector. There's still sector blocks, but the mega sector blocks are so much better now. Are so much better than what we had before. That's too fast. That's not the engine you should have on. That's the engine. Enter Draylon system. If the game ever loads. Load game. So the command has ordered us to take part in a battle readiness exercise. The computer will record any hits as damage and even deactivate affected systems, but our weapons have been reconfigured so we cannot inadvertently damage another Federation ship. Our target today is the USS Athens, commanded by Captain Tavala. The Athens has been upgraded with new systems that should make it a formidable opponent, so Starfleet is sending the USS Carlisle to support us during the battle. Oh, the Carlisle. Yeah. Why don't you just hang back? That's adorable!
She's a command cruiser.
Yep. Did we win? You participated in the war game? Okay. Anytime now.
Killed it too fast.
Did what just happened? Did that escort literally just explode for no reason? There's four ships here. There were four ships here. There's me, you, and the Athens. And an escort that I no longer can see. We killed it too fast, so scripted event is scripted, yeah. So it literally just died. It literally just died because... whatever. Captain Carlisle has been destroyed. I'm hailing the Athens on all channels. And yeah, it is a command cruiser. but it's not responding. Recommend we release the computer lock on our weapons and attempt to disable the Athens. If we don't, we may suffer the same fate as the Carlisle. I think it was the Carlisle was killed by plot radiation. Yeah, that's a dot. That's a dot, but thankfully not an AoE. Oh, look, they're disabled again. Okay. The most advanced...
Combat home fighters weren't needed.
The most advanced tech in Starfleet. They're a formidable opponent. Don't take them lightly.
Curb stomp. By two Galaxy-class starships.
I'm pretty sure the Kazon gave me more of a fight than that. The Athens has been disabled.
They did.
They did. And there is no response to our hails. Recommend we send an away team on board to investigate. Send an away team to investigatable. Who to bring? Let's go ahead and bring... Let's go ahead and bring third. Whatever. Captain Scans determined the safest place to beam in was cargo hold 4, but we needed to make our way to the bridge. According to the Starfleet records, the Athens wasn't carrying cargo. The hold should be empty. We should see what they're carrying. It might help us understand what happened. Hi! The crew of the ship are not humanoid in origin. They're Undine. The entire crew has been replaced. We could be in a very dangerous situation, but if they're in human form, they'll be as vulnerable to our weapons as any human would be. Lima said something. These are stockpiles of isomorphic injectors. Hey, it has ISO in the name. I was right. Captain, this is the drug the Undine used to maintain a humanoid form. It was ISO plot radiation that killed the Carthage.
The Carlisle.
The Carthage Isle. And who knew a command battlecruiser looks like a shitty typhoon from inside?
Oops.
I mean, you do have a new interior kit, Cryptic. You've had it for like a couple years now? Seriously? I do like that the background...
The Roomba in here, I vaporized one of them.
You vaporized somebody? Who'd you vaporize?
Arc 14, E double crit X.
Ah. Yeah, I'm not feeling it with this rainbow gun. Let's see, what else? Oh, there we go. Rainbow gun is not thrilling me. Then again, TR-16 ain't exactly thrilling me either. Ow. Search cargo. Okay. That's not thrilling me either. Oh, yeah, there we go. Is that like a Ramelan shoddy that you have? Ah! We lost Lord Ice. Oh, we lost him. Yeah, he's not a... hasn't sent me anything on Skype yet, either. The game servers have been... twitchy. Although, three for the rest of this mission might be an interesting handicap, at the least, considering we're so goddamn OP at this point. Let's see. Send him a message over Skype. So yeah, I kind of like this gun. Die! And then recharge. Although, it goes through fire. It goes through its power pretty quick. I think there is a way to reload it. Does that reload it faster? Does this reload it faster? Does this reload it faster? Does that reload it faster? No! I know there's a way to recharge it faster. But, oh, damn. Ice is just gone. Ice is just offline. His internet must have died. Oh well. Okay, well, it was pretty late for him anyways, so let's go ahead and tackle this. Yeah, this isn't thrilling me either. Let's just go back to the rainbow machine gun. The, anti-chronoton infused tetrion full auto rifle. Yeah, sure. We'll call it that. It kinda... it looks Voth, almost. Examine cargo. Let's see. There are enough isomorphic injectors in this cargo bay, to supply hundreds of Undine. The entire ship could be overrun. It's a command battle cruiser! It's got a crew of thousands! So, hundreds... Captain, we should get to the bridge if we need to get control of the ship. I think it's at least 2,000. It's more crew than a galaxy, for certain. Yes, they have dragged Lord Ice off, it seems. There's too much damage to the Athens to use the turbo lift, sir. However, there is a Jeffries tube nearby. We should take it up as far as we can and then look for another way to access the bridge. Access the bridge, yes. I'm doing a Bane voice for no reason. This deck has been mostly recreational areas, the holodecks and the mess hall, but you should be able to find a way to access the bridge. Captain, someone has activated the emergency beacon in their comm badge. I can isolate the signal. It's coming from near the mess hall. Shouldn't that person be, like, dead by now if they did that on a ship overrun by Undine? Okay. You're no longer out of uniform. That's good. Once upon a time, he would spawn in, like, the old Sierra uniform. Now he's rocking, like, Starfleet's, more classy, modern look. Don't hurt me! Wait, you're not with them, are you? I don't know what they are, but they aren't like us. I'm supposed to be on shore leave on Deep Space Nine, but I came back to the ship last night to get some things. I was in my quarters, and I remember hitting my head on something, and when I woke up, we were under attack, and the shields were failing. I peeked out to see what was going on, and I saw... It was horrible! Look, you probably want to get to the bridge, right? Those creatures are guarding all the direct paths. If you take the lifts or any of the main corridors, they'll catch you. But I can show you a way to get there, if you'll take me with you. Okay, let's go. My head's so woozy. If you go back in your quarters to gather a few things, it's going to be more woozy. Hello. Head's still woozy. Pro Starfleet moves here. Starfleet security training at its finest. There we go. I'll protect you. Let's see. Give me this. Yeah, just walk into fire there. Just walk ahead of us. Just walk into the Undine. Just walk into it. Just walk into it. Feel those Undines shooting you. This is what happens. This is what happens. This is what happens. And you do it again. Okay, type. I keep saying type. Lord Ice is alive. Do not go into your quarters. Do not go into your quarters. You're a scumbag. You're a scumbag. Oh, I almost forgot. I need my things. That's the whole reason I was on the ship when all this happened. I won't be a minute. You'll protect me while I go get my stuff, right? No! I'll fucking pistol whip you and drag you to the bridge with me! Asshole! Ugh. Oh, joy. Accept. Okay. Snare him up and grenade. Ouch. Why ouch? Oh yeah. Apparently the game crashed so hard on Lord Ice that it forced a complete restart of his computer. That's happened to me before too. Oh, that happened to me before on friggin' XP. Apparently, oh, not the game, his video card. Yeah, that happened to him on Windows 10. It's one of the reasons why I'm not using Windows 10. Let's see. Got it! Man, if I had lost my Captain Proton Holo novels, I'd be miserable. Okay, are you ready to go to the bridge? I should... Motherfucker, I should fucking... I don't know, I will fucking tombstone pile driver your ass when this is over, dude. Oh, I needed your help to walk down a hallway to find a Jeffrey's tube. Great. That's great. Admiral, you can access the bridge through here. This way should be clear. This way should be clear. Yeah, I had it right. I think I should beam aboard your ship now, just to be safe. Good luck. You couldn't have just fucking told me this was over here. Like, you had to, like, make me wait outside while you, like, got your friggin'... Well, you got, like, a friggin' holo novel. You couldn't have just said, hey, there's a Jeffrey's tube down the hall. You can get to the bridge from there. The ensign is transporting to our ship now. If we're lucky, the Jeffrey's tube will get us to the bridge. If we're lucky. I should make him go through it first. You and I are gonna have words.
I'm on my way.
On your way to this instance, or on your way to the bridge?
I'm hoping it'll sync our instance when we both try to go to the bridge.
Okay.
If not, we'll kick double.
Alright. Are you on the bridge?
I'm at the part where...
Okay, I'll stand here and, I'll stand here and chill. The bridge is just up ahead. Ensign Longworth was right after all. We've bypassed a lot of their security. I recommend that we look for Captain Tavala, sir. Find Captain Tavala. Is he going to get his crap now? You know, you're on the bridge.
That
you can't. you're on the bridge. You can't tell when a turbo lift is not being used. Like, it's like in, it's like in 2800. Like, you can't tell that, like, nobody's in that turbo lift. Like, it was a really cool moment, but still, you can't tell.
And hold on. Now I can continue the escort.
Now you can walk down a hall with him.
Out of curiosity.
Out of curiosity, what? Yeah, you're still popping. Separate bridges. good stuff. Good stuff. Let's beam out and beam back in. We should be checkpointed. We're at the same point in the mission anyway, so hopefully it'll just drop us into the same instance. This game. It's unfucking believable. All right, continue revealed. I had third with me, so where's third? There he is.
Oh, I do not want to break the image of four.
All right, reveal your secrets. The bridge is just up ahead. Read that already. Hi, guys! I can cure a flashbang by using adrenaline. I'll just juice myself on synthetic adrenaline! Because that's how it works. Oh, look, everything's dead. Never go first! And there's a third security team, which will appear somewhere. Oh, right there.
What's the third security team?
Defeat Captain T'Valla. Except it's not Captain T'Valla. So be it. The strong survive, and you are weak. How come they keep saying this after we've been consistently kicking their ass for like 5 years? Get a frickin' clue! It's a good thing help showed up when it did. This could have been... What? We destroyed them! We wrecked their shit! This could have been ugly. Captain, there's an emergency hail from our ship. An Undine ship has appeared and it's attacking. We need to return to our ships immediately. Well, if it's attacking, we'd probably do better getting this ship operational, considering our ship's shields are up, but... sense! It does not fucking make. Okay, back to the muck with you, Captain. We've got more trouble. It's a good thing the Zodiac showed up or we'd be vapor by now. It's keeping the enemy ship occupied, but we need to lend a hand. Reinforcements are on the way. Uh-huh. Okay, whatever.
Holy shit, it's a Jupiter.
Is it a Jupiter?
Yes.
Oh, there is a Jupiter right there. The Undine ship has returned to fluidic space, and it looks like all the Undine on the Athens transported off the ship. We were able to capture a large supply of their isomorphic injectors, however, maybe our scientists can put them to good use and find a way to modify our scanners or even create a weapon that we can use against the Undine. Stephanie Corps of Engineers is sending a team to tow the Athens back to a starbase for inspection. Oh, and Captain Goris says we passed our combat inspection with flying colors.
Wasn't that just special?
Why, like, do they have transporters on Undine ships? I thought they just landed on you, because they didn't care about, like, vacuum.
It's like, transporters don't...
Huh? What's that you say? We plot required transporters, therefore transporters. Yeah, okay. Just like the radiation that destroyed the Carthaginians. The Carthaginian, whatever the hell it was called. The Carnegie? The carnage, the Carthagiage. I have a weapon that works against the Undine. Big guns, yeah. It's pretty much what this game breaks down to. Well done. Starfleet wasn't expecting that kind of opposition when they arranged that combat training exercise, but you handle it with your usual skill, backed up by an entire fleet. We're on the hunt for the Undine that was posing as Captain Tavala, and we're looking into what happened to the rest of the Athens crew. Unfortunately, at this time, we have more questions than answers, which is what Terradome was supposed to answer. But, it no longer exists. Basically, the point of Terradome was you finally find where they've been dragging all the people they've been replacing. Yeah, we now know where Sulu is. That was, like, the big... That was kind of the stealth pun of the whole mission, is you find Sulu, finally. At the end of the game. It's like, where's Sulu? Here! That Sulu was an imposter! If you don't know what that is, like early in the game, when the game first launched, nobody could fucking find Sulu, apparently. Like, he was in Admiral Quinn's office, like, right next to Admiral Quinn. Fucking nobody knew where he was, though. So, like, you would hear, like, people, like, screaming out in, like, zone chat, "Where's Sulu?" And it would, like, take on a life of its own. And that's what Terror Dome was supposed to be. Terror Dome was, like, the punchline to that joke, is you find Sulu, like, in this, like, Undine mind drain place thing. Yeah, the Winters replaced Sulu for a while after launch, and then Sulu re-replaced Winters. Yeah, before the launch of the Enterprise F. Why you feel old? Don't feel old. But anyways, that's Suspect and War Games. Next time, try to do this in a more reasonable hour and try to maybe bring along some extra along. Try to get a bigger team together for, let's see, Cardassians, for Shutdown, Rapier, Forging Bonds. There's a lot to go through. I've done the Long Night, so I'm not going to bother with the Long Night, because I've already done that one. But yeah, Shutdown, Rapier, and Forging Bonds will probably be the next one. And then, yeah. And try to put a team together for that. I don't really care about, like, immersion like I usually do in Rise of the Red Shirt. This is just to cover the Cardassian stuff before it gets replaced and dummied out and all that stuff. And most of these missions and the things that happen in them cease to exist. Because they're old. They're super old. They're like, these missions are like launch type missions. So, thank you for joining me, Ice. For these two missions, I'm sorry the game crashed your graphics card. And thank you, ladies and gents, for joining me. Or gents and lady, which is more likely. Yeah, it was Windows 10 that crashed his graphics card. That's why I'm still on 7. I see that Windows icon. I see you in the taskbar. You can go to hell. I know what's in Windows 10. I know Cortana's watching me. Screw that. It did that an hour after I played SC2, StarCraft 2, Starfleet Command 2. StarCraft. So an hour after Windows 10 killed his graphics card an hour after he played like Starfleet, what the hell? StarCraft 2 on his machine. So yeah. Windows 10. It's your creepy stalker that crashes your graphics card constantly. Too much strain causes Windows 10 to crash vid cards sometimes. Yeah. I'm going to stay on 7, thank you. I was interested in Windows 10 until all the stuff about how deeply integrated Cortana is into Windows 10 came out, and then I thought twice real quickly about Windows 10. Turns out I was right, because Windows 10, you have no privacy on Windows 10. In fact, Microsoft changed their terms of service at the beginning of August. So basically, you have no privacy if you're using any Microsoft service whatsoever, which is not good. Which is not something... Yeah. I'm staying on 7 with some degree of reluctance. I'm thinking the next PC I have is going to be running like Linux Mint or something. Or some flavor of Linux that emulates Windows stuff really well. Because I am a plebe. I'm a Linux pleb. I'm a filthy casual. But that has been Suspect and War Games. And I'll see you guys later.